Hello, friends.
Welcome back to another grocery haul. And I just wanted to give a quick shout out to Marie's Kawaii World, one of my favorite YouTubers. And this is one of her shirts that she sells as part of her merch. And I'll leave the link down below. I'm not sponsored. I'm just a fan of hers. Today, Tom and I went to the grocery outlet bargain market. Like I've said before, in these kinds of hauls from this store, you kind of don't know what you're gonna find there. It's kind of like vintage shopping. These stores carry a lot of overstock or things that are gonna be going bad soon. Whatever you find may not be there next week. So it's kind of cool when you find something, you can stock up and it's reduced price, so you can buy more of it. Whatever. Also, I've been really getting into some cookbooks, specifically one by Aveline Cushy and Wendy Esco called The Changing Seasons Cookbook. I was up all night looking at the recipes and reading about springtime foods. If you guys don't know, I practice macrobiotics, which is a lifestyle that really relies on the support of your environment. To have support of your environment, you can eat in line with nature, and that means eating in line with the seasons, eating what's local to you, and a whole lot of other things. I'm so happy that it's the spring season, and I'm really excited to try out some spring recipes from the Changing Seasons cookbook. The first thing, just to restock, maple syrup. We use maple syrup in place of sugar because it's more natural. It doesn't spike your blood sugar as much. It also has some minerals remaining in it, unlike regular sugar or other kinds of sweetener deplete you of minerals. It's a better choice. And we also got some more organic pinto beans because I just eat more beans. Yeah, they're really good for detoxifying your liver, and also they have a lot of fiber. And got some broccoli and cauliflower. I mean, partly because this is just like a staple, but also because there are some broccoli and cauliflower recipes I want to try out for spring. And we also got some plums. I used to have a plum tree when I was growing up. We had such a big tree and it just always provided so much fruit, all the fruit that covered the ground. We also had a fig tree with the figs, a layer of plums and figs in our backyard. And it was more of a nuisance, you know, walking around them. Sometimes, honestly, I remember, sometimes I wouldn't wear shoes, or if I did wear shoes, like, I just remember fruit being on the bottom of my feet all the time. And then also, of course, having to clean up the backyard and all that stuff. We definitely did eat plums, and they definitely were a part of my childhood. I don't think we've ever bought plums because we had such an abundance of plums growing up, and I kind of maybe got sick of them maybe, or just took them for granted. But in the Changing Seasons cookbook, there are some recipes, some dessert recipes, a plum tart, or if you're someone like me who has to kind of avoid flour products or baked goods, there's also an alternative, stewed plums, which sounds kind of gross. But if you look at the recipe, it actually sounds very appealing when you actually look at what's in it and how to make it. That's something I want to make. And then this is another restock, is just this raw tahini. And I showed you guys this in another haul, but this tahini actually kind of has a different texture. It's just raw tahini, just sesame seed butter, not roasted. But I feel like the way that it's, I don't know, blended is a little bit different because it really reminds me of ricotta cheese. If you're someone who's trying to let go of dairy and you want to find some kind of alternative for ricotta in certain recipes, I think this is a good replacement. Of course, if you add some other stuff to make it taste a little bit more like cheese, but that's how the texture is. And then also just another bag of organic broccoli is just a staple. And so then kind of like the big find is Tom and I, we don't really buy too much ice cream, partly because it's not really recommended in a macrobiotic lifestyle, just because freezing energy is just not really good for us. But of course, we grew up in America. Children grow up eating ice cream. It's part of our culture. And also, when it gets really hot, it's a nice treat. Not advocating that it's healthy. I'm just saying a lot of even vegan ice creams are made with refined white sugar. And like I said, Tom and I don't really eat refined white sugar. We try to avoid it as much as possible. Found this brand at Whole Foods called Totes Oats, and it's made with oat milk and sweetened with dates. And usually at Whole Foods, it's maybe like $7. And we found it at the Bargain Market for $1.99. And they only had the peanut butter flavor, but we bought a whole bunch of them. So we bought this peanut butter flavor called Peanut Butter Monster. And honestly, if I'm gonna be real, people, I would say this flavor specifically is just okay. I feel like the chocolate flavor is a bomb. If you're gonna try any of them, try the chocolate flavor, it's so good. And then the vanilla flavor, I think was okay too, but I was actually expecting this one to be better than it was because I really love peanut butter. But I have a dessert that I formulated. And what you do is you put a scoop of this, you put a scoop of your choice of peanut butter, you put a scoop of brown rice syrup, honestly, because I feel like brown rice syrup really tastes like caramel, but you can do maple syrup or barley malt, although barley malt does have an acquired taste, to put it lightly. And then sprinkle some peanuts on top, sprinkle a little bit of raw sea salt, and then pour some plant milk on top. And then it's just like a little like peanut butter sundae kind of thing. And it tastes so yummy. Also, you can mix this with the chocolate flavor and mix it up, and it's like a peanut butter chocolate swirl. If you're a fan of bananas and you don't have anything against bananas, I think this would taste good with either some like just fresh bananas chopped up, and of course add some peanut butter, maybe some peanuts. I think that will make a really good little sundae. Also, I feel like if you blend this with some plant milk and maybe some frozen bananas, that would be a nice like peanut butter banana shake. But anyway, we stocked up. We got like 1, 2, 3, 4, and we have some more in here, 6, 7. And we bought another container of ice cream, and we saw our postman on his lunch break. And we came up to him and we're like, hey, you want some ice cream? We were talking to him for a minute, and then there was this lady that always stands outside of our grocery store, and she's always like advocating for animals. Like, she has a little booth, a little, you know, collecting signatures, trying to get donations and stuff for animals, animal shelters. We're friends with her now, and so we offered her some of this ice cream, but turns out she's allergic to peanuts. Next time we'll buy her some vegan ice cream that she can eat. We actually gave one of these to our neighbors, that we always exchange food with them. Sometimes they make stuff and they give us a little bit. Sometimes we make stuff, we give them a little bit. Sometimes we buy extra. It's just nice. I really like that dynamic we have with our neighbors, and I think that's a good thing if you can do that with your neighbors, to show community and to show support and show that you love them. And if you have something of good quality, it's nice to share it with people and give people some of your excess. Two things that Tom already started cooking that we got today is actually these organic Brussels sprouts. And Tom and I have been eating more Brussels sprouts once again because they are a vegetable that's seasonal for spring. And I actually just posted a really cool Brussels sprout recipe over on my Patreon if you want to check that out. There's so many more ways to cook Brussels sprouts. And again, help you to align with your environment, with the spring energy, to help you feel more at peace and accept all the blessings that this time of year has to offer. Also, another spring kind of vegetable is the baby arugula. Anything baby, any kind of baby green, any leafy green, little sprout, vegetable, wild grasses are really good for springtime. And once again, there are so many spring recipes that I want to get into utilizing these beautiful spring vegetables. Thanks so much for watching this video. You can join my Patreon for more cooking tips and healthy recipes, extra content. I'll see you guys in my next video. Peace.